Hey everyone, my name is Austin Paul, and I'm a content creator, filmmaker that inspires other creators how to create better shots with tutorials like this. In today's tutorial, I'm gonna teach you guys how to take a boring product shot like this and really make it much more impactful using Adobe Stock assets. As you can see, this is where we started, and this is where it ends up. We're giving this shot a much more cinematic, wow, eye-catching, scroll-stopping look to it by easily placing a video stock asset from Adobe onto it. The best thing about using Adobe stock assets and their stock footage is that it's super simple and super easy to use, and you can make something impactful within seconds. All right, so here's a scenario. You're filming something for one of your clients. Let's just say it's a product. It is an unlabeled product. And what we need to do is add some spice to it. This is a spicy drink, and we need to add some fire to it. The reason why I'd be using stock footage instead of actually shooting a fire is two reasons. One, because we don't have a high-speed camera and can't afford one, and they're expensive to use. And two, for safety reasons, I don't want to light my house on fire. I'm gonna go into Adobe Stock and I'm gonna search for something like a fireball. Something super easy, and I'm just gonna scroll through until I find the one that looks right to me. A fireball that's coming in from the background. Boom, super impactful, super cinematic, and we're gonna download that and we're gonna take that right into Adobe After Effects. If you've never used Adobe After Effects before, that is okay, because this is a very easy tutorial and you can follow right along. And I promise you, if you learn how to do this, you can take any of the stock footage and up-level any of your shots in minutes, and it's super easy. And this is a great starting point for anybody that wants to learn and make their content better. All right, so here is our beginning shot, just this bottle shot. All I did was take two lights with some diffusion paper and slowly turn them up and then turn them back down to create a heat for the fireball. And then I just had a nice backlight right there. That is it. It's just three simple lights, and it just does that. It's pretty much just slowly turning on the lights. What we're gonna do first is bring in our fireball, which is this shot right here. And right away, here's our fireball. Shot looks great. Obviously, it's just covering the whole product. So what we wanna do is a few things. Two things to think of is we don't want the fireball just to go through our product, so we're gonna have to separate our product a little bit. I'm gonna show you guys how in a second. And then also, a fireball, if it's coming from behind and this is on a podium, we wanna make sure that the fireball is not going below this, because that doesn't make any sense if it's behind it. So you just gotta think about those things when wanting to make this realistic. Lastly, when you're dropping this fireball in, you just want to make sure that it's timed up. Luckily, I've already kind of timed it up, but you want to make sure it comes out once this light is turning on. So if it's right there, and then all of a sudden as it gets bigger, boom, all the light turns on. These are pretty much perfectly timed. I can go on the transparency here, show you guys a little bit. Boom, bam, beam. See, just like that, they're turning on together. So how do we do this? It's simple. First thing we're going to do is we're going to just pre-compose this layer right here and say move all attributes, press OK. And we're going to go to where it's a little bit brighter. And we're just going to mask out this podium so that the fireball doesn't go past that. Really easy. Go around like that. And boom. And then I'm just going to do a little bit of feather to make it a little bit easier. Like that. Now already that's giving us a much more realistic look, because the fireball is gonna be behind it. Now that we have our mask right here, the problem is we can't see because obviously it's on a black background. All we're gonna do is take the fire asset, we're gonna go up to layer and go to blending mode and go to screen. And that's gonna get rid of all the black right there. And now you can see it is see-through and we have our mask going on, easy peasy, like so. Obviously right now our fireball is in front of it. So again, how do we fix that? Really easy. What we're gonna do is take our bottle, I'm gonna duplicate it, and then I'm just gonna raise that up above our fire shot, which is right here, one sec. And I'm gonna go to the brightest part again, and all we're gonna do is start to mask it. So what we wanna do to mask it is just go right around the bottle like this. I'm gonna do a quick and easy mask here. I did a really quick mask, and now it's behind the bottle, And what we do from there with the bottle is that we just do a feather. I did a really sloppy mask just to show you guys how to do it. But what we do is do a feather like this, and then maybe crush the expansion a little bit so it goes in. It's a little too high for a feather, but we do something like that. And that's already looking a lot better. But as we know, a bottle is see-through, so I would just drop the transparency by pressing T. Pressing T, and then just showing a little bit of the bottle like so, because we want to show that the flame is coming from behind the bottle like that, right? So now you can see the flame a little bit in there, which helps a little bit. And eventually, if you do it not as sloppy as I just did right there, you will get something that's a little bit cleaner like this one. And as you can see with the top bottle, I have an 84% opacity. And then as it gets closer, I kind of scale it down, because otherwise 84, I think it kind of blows out a little bit too much of the bottle. So then I just toggle it to let it go a little bit darker as it gets closer to here. So, but you can see that flame coming in, and as it gets brighter, boom. Now we have our top bottle and we have our flame all going well, but it's not looking very realistic. So the next thing that we got to do is add a glow, and a glow is just going to add a little bit to the bottle like this, and going to make it feel a little bit more real when everything is coming in. And the reason for that is because when a fire is exploding and going around glass, it's going to glow a little bit. And the way that we do this is very simple. We're just going to take this asset again like this. So Command D, copy it. We're gonna bring it above our top bottle, and then we're gonna pre-compose like so. Press OK. So now we have pre-composed that. And what I'm gonna do is go to our top bottle. Now we have the asset in here, so what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna take this mask that we cut out from earlier when we were cutting out our bottle, and we're gonna go to our fire that we put here. I'm just gonna call this glow. Right, and I'm gonna create a mask by pressing Command V, and that's gonna mask right around our fire. And as you can see, when I turn it on, it's gonna cut right there. And what we're gonna do now with it is we're gonna do a few things. We are going to go to layer, we're gonna go to blending mode, and we're gonna make sure that we put that screen back on, because every time you pre-compose, it disappears. And then we're gonna turn this one down quite a bit. So this one's gonna go over the top of our bottle like this. So it's gonna create that little bit of glow for us. We can even go in here and go to blur. And then use something like Gaussian blur and easily kind of blur it out just a little bit, because it's gonna be glowing off the bottle. So it's not gonna, it shouldn't be as crisp as the actual flame itself. So the original one that it is at 13. So I think it's a little hot. I'm gonna turn it down just a little bit, probably to right there. And maybe turn down our blur just a smidge so we can see a little bit of detail. But already what that's doing, as you can see, is adding that glow to the shot, which just gives it a little bit more realism. Beautiful. There's a bunch of other things you can do to kind of up-level these that I'm not gonna waste your guys' time with, but you can even add some more awesome kind of assets like these background sparks. So for example, if I turn all these off real fast, I can add in these background sparks right here. And I'm just gonna do the same thing by doing screen, and then I'm gonna blur them out a little bit. And then I'm just gonna use some opacity right here and have them turn on when the fireball comes on. So like right there, there's our fireball, right? And then, here, let me use this one, oops. There's our fireball. And here's our top bottle. And then we add our glow. And then that's just gonna add a little bit more texture to the background as this fireball comes in. Awesome, just like that. I think that's looking great. And so the next thing that we can do is add some movement to this shot. And all I'm gonna do is take all of these, go Command Shift, or click Shift. I'm gonna take all these clips, click Shift, go to Pre-compose and move it. Now we have this, and we can use something like Transform, or we can just use Scale and Position to create that impactful movement. And all I'm gonna do is go Scale, Position, and I'm gonna zoom in quite a bit like this. Position looks good. And then as the flame goes all the way to its precipice or climax, I'm gonna go back to 100 And we're gonna go like this, go to keyframe assistant and make a nice smooth S curve to it. And that's gonna create. Now I think it should actually stop right here. So I'm gonna bring that in a little bit more. And then the last thing I'm gonna do is add some motion blur to it by just clicking that right here to enable motion blur. And this, and when you turn on your keyframes, that allows you to create some motion blur with your movement of your keyframes. All of that looks good. The last thing that we could do is go like this. And what I can do is split this layer and we can add a little bit of shake to this, which is always fun. And what we do for that is we go to position. We hit the Alt or Option key, go and click that. And we type in wiggle. And then the wiggle numbers are gonna be your first number and then comma your second number. So it's the amount of wiggle or movement that you wanna create by the frequency. So we have to play around with this a little bit, but we can do 5, 10 and go boom, enter. And let's see how that goes. That's creating a little bit of shake, beautiful. Let's try to make this a little bit more wild by doing 25. There we go. And that's beautiful, I love it. It's creating that shake for us, boom. And as you can see, as it's shaking, as we get here, it's gonna go off the edge a little bit. So what we can do is just go like that. And we can even make it a little bit crazier if we want. Let's go 15 and 25. So this is gonna be how much it shakes. This is the frequency of what it's shaking. And that's just gonna create that shake for us. Boom. Love it. And we can pre-compose this one more time. And we're gonna scale up a little bit. As you can see, we're losing a little bit of edge right here. So we're just gonna go to scale, go 101, boom, problem solved. And then you eventually get something that looks like this. Within minutes, we've taken our shot from this boring shot into a very cinematic, Hollywood-esque looking fireball flame product shot. And you can do this just like me. Thank you to Adobe Stock Assets for sponsoring this video. If you guys enjoyed this tutorial, please like, share, and subscribe. And until next time.